The process of 3D modeling in 3ds Max. Okay. So first we will start with setting up the file. You go to 3ds Max. This is your 3ds Max software. So here you go to customize, go to unit setup. Here you will get this unit setup. So now, as I have seen in your file, you are using fit. Okay. So fit 10 inches. So what we will do in 3ds Max also, we will be using this fit 10 inches. So go to US standard. Okay, so here you have the default unit as fit. Let it be like this. And always use it with fit with decimal inches. Don't go for fractional inches because you cannot type 1 by 2. It is easy to type 0.5. Okay, so I use here fit with decimal inches. Okay. So now I have set up my file. This is my first process. Second is how to apply this. Now, as I have seen in your project, you have a circular area of, I think this is 30 feet. 60 feet is the diameter of the outer circle and 20 feet is the diameter of the inner circle. So now what I do, I go to 3ds Max. So just I'm showing you an example of one object. Here I cannot do a direct cylinder. Here I have to create a 2D shape because this area is a part of scuba diving and it is a hole here. So that's why you have to use 2D shapes. Okay. So what I do here, I go to create. This is your create. I go to shapes. This is your shapes. I go to circle. This is your circle. Then I create a circle in my front view like this. Now actually I should not create it in front view. I should create this circle in the top view, okay, because this is the view of top. So this is the common mistake which people do, that's why I highlighted it. So go to the top view and create the circle. See, I don't need these grids here. Press G on the keyboard, the grids will be hidden. So now I have drawn a circle. Now go to modify. This is your modify here. I show again, this is your modify. Here inside that you have got circle. So now select this radius here and type here 60 feet. Get for the feet symbol in the keyboard, which is to the left of enter. And it is only the feet key, not shift and this. Okay, if you press shift and that, it will become inches. So just press the feet key, which is to the left of enter key. Then press enter. Okay. So now you can zoom extends here from this place like this. So now you can see the circle is made. So now what I want to do, I want another circle of I think I have done a mistake. The radius is 30 feet. Sorry. The radius is 30 feet. I have typed 30 feet here. Okay, like this. So now what I will do, I will create a copy of this circle. So how to create a copy? Go to edit, click on clone and use the option copy, not instance. I will tell you where to use instance. You use copy here. Okay. So now a copy has been created exactly over it. So now you just go to the radius part and change it to 10 feet because your diameter was 20 feet. So the radius is 10 feet. Okay. So this is 10 feet, this is 30 feet. So we have created the shape here. So now when I want to create a 3D of this, I want a hole inside. Okay. But if I extrude it directly, this will be individually extruded, this will be individually extruded, you will not get a hole. So how to get that? You have to know the process. First select this top circle, right click over it. Okay. So you'll get an option convert to editable spline. Convert to editable spline. So once the object is converted to editable spline, so what you can do is you can go to you can see the editable spline coming over here. So now you search for attach here. Go to attach, click on attach, and then click on this smaller circle. This is your smaller circle, click on this. So now I have attached this with this. So now I go to my modifier list. Now I will search for extrude here. I click on extrude. So now this has become a 3D, leaving a hole in the center. So now you can extrude it for say 1 feet or 2 feet according to your requirement. You can just extrude and place it. Okay. So now we have created the portion over here. So now let me come to the bottom portion. So now here you say that this area is 20 feet and this area is 100 feet. Okay, so now this is a box structure. So what I do, I go to create. So now we were doing it in shape. See, if we do it something in shape, we have to create the shape and then apply the extrude modifier. But if you are directly creating a box shape, you don't have to apply extrude modifier. You can directly create through geometry. So now I go to geometry, I go to box. In the top view, I create a box here like this. I zoom out this area like this. I just pan it like this. I go to the box. I create like this. Okay. Now roughly I have created it. Now go to the modify. See, this is your length. This I need as 100 feet. So type 100 feet here. This is my 20 feet. This is 20 feet here. And now this is the height. See, this part I couldn't understand well in your drawing. So now you justify from the left view that what will be the height factor of this. Will this be parallel to this, or is this area below this? That you have to judge yourself and place it over here. For example, in the left view, if I just move and place it here like this, sorry, undo. So now I select this area. Select this area and just move it to the bottom. Now you can see this level has gone to the bottom. So I don't think your level is in the bottom, it is straight, so keep it straight. So you have to decide where to place it. Means I have created in the top view, then I can place it in any of the views. Okay, so now this is the second part which I think we have done. So now you just check that this one is in the center to, is in alignment with center to this or not. I think I have created the second part of your object. Okay, so now I think it is looking so this is a process. Like, each and every object cannot be done with the same process, so we have to adopt different techniques for creating different kinds of objects. So now what you do is, so now you have got some trees here. So now I show you how to place some ready-made trees. We will change the trees in the future. You go to create here. You go to AEC extended. Here you go to foliage. See, you may not get the exact tree which you might be planning, but you just place any one of the tree for reference. We can replace it anytime afterwards also. I choose this one and I just place it here. See, this is a dummy presentation now, so don't go by the detail of the designs. You just go by the placement, that I am able to place things in the correct place. Don't go by objects. Objects can be replaced at any time. You have to learn whether you can perfectly place the objects or not. That is more important. Okay, so foliage, it was here, create, geometry, AEC extended, foliage. And inside that you had your tree, you have some only four or five choices. Use it and place it. Okay, so now this I have placed as my tree. And what else you can have extra? See, now go for submarine. See, I don't have a ready-made submarine now, and it will take time to build the submarine. But before building a thing and placing it, so what people do is, to have a feel of the object at a certain place, they create a dummy 3D object and place it over there. For example, I come back to standard, I go to extended primitives here. Okay, so here you see I have got a thing called capsule. Okay, I think capsule resembles something like a submarine. Or you can go for an oil tank also. So oil tank, I go to the front view. So this time I don't go to top view, I go to the front view, create something like this, just zoom over it, just place it like this. Okay, so So this is just a dummy object for a submarine, like as you have placed something like this for submarine, a circular portion. So I have created a cylindrical type of portion, and you just move and place it where you need. So this is not the final submarine which we are going to place, but this is a dummy object which you place in the position of a submarine. So this will help you in developing further, because in a production what happens is there is a person who is called a layout artist, and the work of the layout artist is to put the correct things in the correct place and judge whether it looks fine or not. And after that the 3D modeler comes and he just replaces this object with an original submarine. The same thing which we will do for boat also. So I do something like a box here, just I create a box here like this, and I assume this as my boat, okay, and I have just placed it. So in your project, placement is very important. Not only yours, everyone's placement is very important. Especially yours is important because you are doing something like underground water experience, underwater experience. So the levels of all these objects which we are placing is not in the same level. I think submarine cannot be over here. Submarine should be somewhere under the water. So the placement should be here. In the same way, but the boat will be above water, the placement of the boat will be here. Okay, so this depends upon your idea. I don't know what you have thought where to place where. So this you have to first create it in 3ds Max. See, if you think that you have placed whatever you want in the correct place, then almost 30% of your work is done, because after that it is just replacing the dummy object with a perfect object, which I will tell you tomorrow. So now you just try to create a file in Max, go to customize unit setup and set the units, then whatever measurements you have, just try to give the exact measurements and create the object like boat. Select this box and just estimate a dimension of this boat, like what will be the length, width, etc., and just type it. So then you will get the exact proportion. Okay. So now here everything you have to do in 1:1. You don't have to scale and give any dimensions. You always give the dimension in 1:1. Like if this is 20 feet, then give 20 feet. You don't have to scale it. Okay. This is the advantage of any 3D software like AutoCAD. So now I think you can do up to this one here. Okay, so you have got landscape. You just place, you can just hold the shift and copy and place some trees here and there wherever you want. Then you have got a foot court. Foot court, I think it will be better if you model it using the box. Okay, like I taught you to model a chair, you are just composing the box and placing to create a chair. In the same way, you can just place this object to create a shop or something like that. So then that is the next portion, which is called texturing, which I will tell you tomorrow. You don't have to bother about texture. Like in the food court, we can give a signage symbol and all, which we can use an image from photograph. How to apply a photograph to the image, I had taught you in materials, but still we will see it in the next portion. So here we have got food court, then you have your shopping also the same. So what you can do as your classwork now is, homework now is, you create some textures for your food court. Okay, textures means, see, when you are creating a model of a food court, what you do, you build the model in thermocol, then you take the size of it and create the Photoshop design of the banner and just paste over it. So what happens is, it looks like a real food court. I think you have done it in this house here. See, you have done this flat house here. So then what you have done, I think you have painted here, but what people do is, I don't know, you have painted it or you have taken a printout of this size and just pasted over that. So this is the same process of texturing in 3ds Max also. You just create some images like this and just create the texture over it. We will just apply it to the box which we have created. So I think this portion is covered. So next we have That is your 2D drawing, yes. Shopping, scuba diving is a simple thing. It is just a watery body here, and that I will tell it in the next part. Information desk counter, this is the counter desk design. So this also you have to design using 2D shapes and all. Okay, try to do it, otherwise I will tell you tomorrow. An example of this shape I can show you in 3ds Max, which you can do. Go to create, go to tube over here. You could have actually used this tube also to create this one, but I have told the attach process because it will be helpful for you in creating lots of other models which cannot be done using tube. Like I have made a tube here, I give a inner radius. See, you have got the modify option here. Okay, this is the modify option. You can increase the outer radius, you can increase the inner radius, you can increase or decrease the height. This object you could have done it through this also. Okay, so no problem. You have learned two options, like creating a 2D shape, attach and extrude, as well as this the ready-made shape. So now what I do, you go to this slice on and just increase this from and to. Now you see you get a arc type of counter which you needed, I think. Okay, like see. This could have done using 2D, but if I am doing it using this ready-made option, it is much easier. Okay, in previous days when we are using the older version of Max, we didn't have this slice option, so we had to do it in through 2D. But here now you have some comfort options and you can do objects very easily. Okay, so now this is how you can create a counter, and you can just add elements for making it attractive. So I think this is the first part. You concentrate on doing this much of it.